Hey folks, Dr. Groovy Scott Grove from groovymusiclessons.com. As it says in the title, we're going to honk if we're horny. What that basically means is we're going to do a car horn sound, which is two notes put together, and we're just going to play it twice, just like you're honking a horn. I got this from The Heart of Rock and Roll by Huey Lewis in the News. It does it a few times in there. And I've always used it in Pink Cadillac for horn noises. I've used it in Mustang Sally because it talks about cars, horn noises. I just use it basically one time in a song. So depending on what songs you play, I might use it two or three times per night is about it. But it's cool to have. Again, I've already made the video already longer than it needs to be, but I'm going to make it even longer than that. So for you people who catch on real quick to one thing, here's what happens, and then I will actually go over it with other folks with more of an explanation and actually backing track and just a little more information for about 5 minutes. So what happens here, I'm going to do it in the key of C, reason being, good old Mustang Sally's in C, so is Heart of Rock and Roll, and that's about it. Plus, because the key of C is where this car horn thing actually sounds most like a car horn, it's just in that sonic range. Okay, so all this is this. If you are playing, like I said, in the key of C, okay, the thing that happens is we go up here to the 8th fret, and we're only going to play the 5th and the minor 3rd, so a flatted 3rd in C. So 8th fret on the B string and the G string, and that is it. It's just a matter of how you phrase it that makes it sound like a car horn. What use is this? I just told you. Okay, dumb lesson, but a good lesson. Otherwise, I wouldn't have had so much fun with it over the decades. So again, yeah, ugly, and you play this against major chords like it would be. You just play it twice. Okay, again, G string, B string, there's no root note. Does it sound better in context? Of course, that's coming if you wait around. Okay, so. And again, in context, it sounds more like a horn. So if you want to check that out in context and just hear a tiny bit more about it, stick around. All right. Okay, folks, thanks for sticking around. Like I said, The Heart of Rock and Roll by Huey Lewis in the News is where I took this from. And again, any car songs, I like to put this in without using it too much. But I've been playing it a lot without actually knowing it, but not phrasing it as a car horn, because it's a pretty basic thing in blues where you would like do the... but phrasing it as a car horn, a whole different ball game, and throwing it after something that mentions a horn or a car is cool to you and maybe a musician out in the audience. And that's about it. But hey, once the moment passes, you're proud of it. Okay, so the guitar for the day, the Dean Baby V in purple. Got a lot of Dean Baby V's in different colors, and put new pickups in, Fender pickups. They actually split into single coils, and I use these groovy decals that are like kind of puffy paint looking. I think they're awesome. Anyway, within a normal context, we've probably been playing this a long time. I know I have. If you're playing along and doing this, okay, so where you're just doing the... Okay, so that's it. You just weren't phrasing it as a car horn. And neither was I until I heard this song and figured out what was going on. So I'm going to play part of the song where it came from and try not to get this copyright stricken. Okay, so here's that part of the song. Listen real close.
I've got it pretty much cued to it. Here it is. Okay. Something everyone should see, then you'll barely hear it. Okay, so after everyone should see. Okay, so that was probably long enough for a copyright strike. We'll see what happens. Okay, so with a backing track on this, you'll see how it fits in. I'll just play this. It's just in C and throw it in. Okay. Again, that's just 8th fret, playing the B string and the G string. That's all it is. And play it from the G string down, because that just actually puts that minor 3rd against a major chord, gives it dissonance against the major chord, which is what kind of makes it effective, okay? Everybody else is playing a major 3rd, you're playing a minor 3rd. So. And I have a George Lynch Dragon 2 Morley wah, which comes in handy. It's a cocked wah thing or a regular wah, both of which can be really effective in this. I'll just hit the button where I have a preset sweep for the cocked wah thing, and you give it a little bit of different tone or with a equalizer that you have. Set up for their Mark Knopfler, I Want a New Drug tune. I Want a New Drug. Oh, mercy. Got the Huey Lewis on the brain. So anyway, you know the tune I'm talking about. So we can actually hit that and then hit the button. And it sounds even more like it. Just give it a little something different. Okay, so by itself, not much of anything, but again, in context, sounds like a car horn, and that's what I'm after today. So that's the end of that lesson, okay? Again, it took way longer to show it than it ever should have, but wanted to get it actually covered and why it works, okay? So you guys stay groovy. I'm going to go pick up mail and go shopping and cash some paychecks. Basically boils down to the honey-do list, all right? Money for Nothing is the name of the tune I was trying to think of by Dire Straits. But anyway, once again, stay groovy. I'll always be groovy. And later on, kids, bye.